Hello everyone! Today we are going to see how to make this mango Shrikhand. So to make a nice Shrikhand just like the ones we get in the store, we need to use thick curd, also called as hung curd. So we'll start off this recipe by making this hung curd. Take a saucepan and place a strainer over it, and then spread a thin cloth over the strainer, and then transfer the curd that we're going to use for this recipe onto the cloth. I am using about 500 grams of curd today. Transfer this curd onto the cloth and then bring the ends of the cloth together and squeeze out all the excess water from the curd. You can also place a heavy bowl over this curd and then squeeze out all the excess water. And you'll have to keep this aside for at least 1 to 4 hours until all the excess water drains out. The longer you keep, the thicker your curd will be. And when you use the thick curd for the Shrikhand also will end up being very nice and thick and creamy. I usually leave this curd in the fridge because I don't want the curd to go sour. But if you live in a colder place or if it's winter, you can leave it out for 1 to 4 hours until all the water drains out. After a few hours, start with the next steps. We will start off by chopping some mangoes. I've taken about half mango and I've put it in a small mixer jar, and I'm adding 2 tablespoons of sugar to it and grind this to make a nice smooth puree. We will need about half to 3/4 cup of mango puree for this recipe. If you need more sugar, you can add more sugar. My mango was sweet enough, so 2 tablespoons of sugar was more than enough. But if your mango is not sweet, then do add more sugar and grind it to a smooth paste. Once this is done, set this aside. And this is after 2.5 hours. Now the water has all drained out, and what's left behind is a nice thick curd. So we'll use this to make the Shrikhand. Transfer the curd to a bowl and we'll start adding the mango puree. I initially added only about half a cup of mango puree to the curd and then mixed it. And then when I tasted it, I felt it needed a bit more mango, so I added a little more. While mixing, you can also add some cardamom powder. If your family likes the taste and flavor of cardamom powder, then do add 1/4 teaspoon of cardamom powder. My family don't like it, so I haven't added. Also, taste as you go, and if you need a little more sugar also, you can add more sugar. But make sure you add only powdered sugar at this step. If you add granulated sugar here, this sugar will not get dissolved. So make sure you add only powdered sugar. Once you mix it all in, then that's it. Our Shrikhand is done. Add as much mango puree as you want. This Shrikhand needs to be refrigerated at least for 1 hour. You can transfer the Shrikhand to your serving bowls and then keep it refrigerated till you serve it. So this is after 1 hour. Before serving, I have chopped some mangoes and I've added it as decoration. You can make this as an evening snack also for your kids. It's a very healthy snack to give. It's made fully with curd and mango. So it's a very nice dessert to serve your kids when they come back from school. Do try it out. It's very tasty. It's much better than the store-bought ones. It's nice and thick and creamy. We've got such a thick Shrikhand because we used hung curd. If you skip that step, you will not get such a thick Shrikhand. It will be a little runny and a little loose. So take the effort and make the hung curd to make the Shrikhand, and it will be very tasty, and you will definitely enjoy this mango Shrikhand during this mango season. You can also make this Shrikhand with other fruits. I've already posted a strawberry Shrikhand. You can check it out. So thank you for watching. Until next time, bye bye.